AI voice agents have been taking over the space for a while now. So the next evolution after that is an AI avatar agent, where we now have an avatar that lip syncs to the audio that's spoken to you from the agent. And today I'm going to show you how to do that. We're looking at Simli. They offer a service like that. And it's a pretty nice service. They have full APIs and everything. If you go into their dashboard, you can see that they have these two pre-made AI avatar agents for you. But what's cool is you can also upload an image and it will convert that to an avatar agent that you can use via API. And so I've created this one right here. There's two ways to do this. You can take these avatars and plug them into your website via a widget, and you can give it a prompt and all of that. It's fairly simple, but you just don't have full control like you would want with an agent, such as function calling, things like that. So what you're going to want to do is use a service like Pipecat. And what Pipecat does is they're similar to LiveKit agents. But instead, Pipecat uses daily. So if you look at their documentation, they have a Simli integration. They also have Tavis, which I haven't tried yet, but I'm going to show you how to use Simli, which is what we just, the website we were just on. So I put together this repo that will do exactly what you want to do for a Pipecat Simli AI avatar agent. You're going to want to follow these instructions. However, there is an issue currently where the Simli Python client needs to be updated for you to use. So I've provided this workaround where you clone their repo and then modify it, and then you can basically use that their client with that modification that we make that we need to run this. And with this Pipecat Simli AI avatar agent, we're going to use the Simli client. We're going to use OpenAI for the LLM. And we're going to use 11 Labs for the voice. And it uses daily under the hood, a lot like what LiveKit does. And I'm actually, I've done LiveKit videos in the past, and I'm going to do a LiveKit Simli video soon. And it's pretty simple. Once you follow these steps, you just run the Python agent, and we'll show you. But if we hop into that Simli client real quick, I'll show you where that edit needs to be made. Click on Simli, and then go to utils. And this value right here, this one, you're going to want to change that to a string value wrapped in quotation marks with the word mono in it, M-O-N-O. Okay. So if we do the git clone and all the setup from the README, you'll see that I've already done it and I kind of just ran it previously. What we'll do is you then in your daily dashboard, you go to rooms, create a room, and then you'll get this URL for the room. And this is important because you're going to want to put this information in your .env file. So when you're ready to run the agent, follow this URL, which I've got right here, and you're going to want to join the room. Okay, so we've joined the room now. And now if we just run the Simli agent, hopefully it works all right. Okay, then run back over here. We should be able to talk to her.
Absolutely. I'm here to help. Just let me know what you need assistance with, and I'll provide a clear and creative response.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. How about you? What can I help you with today?
Yeah, I'm okay. What's your name?
My name is Tasha. I'm here to assist you with anything you need. What would you like to chat about?
What should I have for lunch?
How about a delicious wrap? You could fill it with grilled chicken, fresh veggies, and your favorite sauce. Or if you're in the mood for something lighter, a colorful salad with quinoa and roasted chickpeas would be great too. What sounds good to you?
Yeah, okay, thanks, Tasha. All right, I'm just gonna put her on mute for a moment.
You're welcome. Just a small note, my name is Tasha, but I appreciate the thought. If you have any other questions or need more ideas, just let me know. Enjoy your lunch.
Okay, thanks. So so that was kind of the demo of it. And you can see it's not fully optimized. This is just right out of the box. So there's probably a lot more we can do to make this better and cleaner. However, this is new tech. It's not gonna be perfect yet, but you can see the direction and trends that this is going. Eventually, this will be a lot cleaner. The voice movements should be a lot better. Everything should just get more improved and just quicker, better over time, right? Yeah, so that's this demo. Pretty straightforward. I kind of rushed through a lot of the setup, but if you follow the README's instructions, you should be able to handle this no problem. If you have any questions or you want to see some features added to this or anything like that, just leave a comment or go ahead and join my Discord if you want to chat about any code or this project at all. So yeah, all right, see you.